Did you know that you can bring data from multiple tools side by side into a single Data Studio? Hi, this is Ahmed from CLWalk with another quick Data Studio tutorial, and today I'm going to show you how to bring data from multiple data sources and add them to a single Data Studio report. Let's see how we can do that. Okay, here we are with a Data Studio report, and in this report we have three metrics from Google Analytics. So the data source is Google Analytics, and we've added three scorecards to show users, sessions, and revenue. This is the basics. This is what we start with when we start creating Data Studio reports. We open Data Studio, we have a canvas, we add some scorecards, and we have a data source, which is now one master view, which is Google Analytics demo account, and this is the name of the view that I'm connected to. But in fact, we are not limited to one data source per page. Actually, each component, each chart on a Data Studio report can be connected to a completely different data source. So for example, here I have another page and I have Google Analytics and Facebook ads side by side. These three scorecards are reading data from Facebook ads. These three are reading from Google Analytics. We can go one step further and actually add Google Ads data into the same reports. We can actually add Microsoft Ads data to the same report. So on this page, we have 12 of the scorecards, and each three of them are getting their data from a completely different data source, and we can see all of them side by side. You'll be pleased to know that it's actually easy to create a report with multiple data sources like this. Let me go to the next page, which has some empty placeholders for us to fill in, and let's go to edit mode and see how we can actually connect different charts, different scorecards to different data sources. First of all, let's duplicate these three. I'm going to right click, choose duplicate, move them to the right, but they are still connected to Google Analytics data source. The only thing I need to do, either for all of them when they're selected like this, or either one by one by selecting each of them, is that I need to click on the data source and choose another data source for this component to get its data from. Now we want it to be Facebook ads data. I already have the Facebook ad data source that is using a Supermetrics connector. And when I replace the data source for this scorecard, you see that the number changes. Now, before it was users, so Google Data Studio tries to guess which field in this data source corresponds to users or is more similar to users and automatically selects this one for us. But actually, let's take a look at the previous page to see what was the actual metric, amount spent. Now let's go to the try page, select this. It is connected to Facebook ad and we want to show amount spent. Drag it, drop it, and that's it. I actually need to change the type of the number from a simple number to a currency, so it shows the actual dollar amount. And we can repeat the same process for the rest of the scorecards. Just click, connect them to Facebook ads, and we are done. The only thing that we need to do is to select the proper field to be represented in that scorecard. So for example, here I have cost per website conversion. I want to, that's it. And I will call it CPA. And I will need to change the type also to currency and US dollars. This is how we do it when we already have a data source available to us, when we already have created the data source. But what if you haven't created the data source yet? You have two options. First, click here and click add data, or click here and click add data. If you click here, you will add a data source to the report itself, but it does not necessarily connect to the scorecard that you've selected. But if you start from here, you're actually changing
the data source for their scorecard, and at the same time, you're creating a new one. So if I want to connect to a new Facebook ad account, for example, here I need to search for connectors for Facebook ads. And here we can see we have a few different connectors available. Supermetrics is there, and another one which I've used recently. Let me see if I can find it. Here it is from Portometrics. This is also a good connector, good data connector for Facebook and Instagram ad. But right now I'm going to select Facebook ad. We're not going to go through all those steps because I'm not logged in into an account that has access to my Supermetrics account and the Facebook ad account that I wanted to connect to. But the process is that first you authorize Supermetrics account, then authorize your Facebook account, and you will click add, and it will create a new Facebook ad data source, which is then connected to this scorecard. And as you've noticed, we can repeat the same process, duplicate them, bring them here, connect them to a Google Ads data source that we already have, or create a new one, and the same for Microsoft Ad. I'm not going to waste time here. Instead, I'm going to go to the previous page when we already have all of these. So if I select these three, you can see that these are connected to Facebook ads. These three are connected to Bing ads, which is exactly what Microsoft Ad was. Please remove this section that I selected these one. And then these three are connected to Google Ads data source, and these three are connected to Microsoft Ads. Okay, so far so good. We know that we can add different data sources to different charts and components on the single page. But there is a limitation, and that's it. One chart, one data source. Here I have a time series chart which is showing the amount spent for this rate range, and is comparing it to the previous 28 days for the Facebook ads datasets. Now, we know that we can also create the same chart on the same page using Google Ads or Microsoft Ads, but the numbers from different data sources cannot be represented or plotted in a single chart. So if I try to edit this page and select this time series chart, I can either show Facebook ads data or I can show Google Ads data. The numbers change, the name of the metrics change, but we cannot have both of them shown on the same chart. We can, of course, show two charts side by side. So make this one a little bit smaller, copy it, paste it, create another one, and then connect the second one to a Facebook ads data. This is, of course, possible. But if you absolutely need to bring data from different data sources into one chart or table, then you need to use a method called data blending to create a blended data source, which is, of course, outside the scope of this short tutorial, but I hope I can make a video on that soon. In the meantime, and without using blended data sources, the only thing that we can do is to show the numbers from different platforms, from different data sources, side by side. Now, as the final tip for this tutorial, let's see how date range filters and filter controls work when we have a page with different charts and components that are getting data from different data sources. So what happens if I try to change impression device? Does it filter all data on all the components or just one of them? What happens if I change the date range? Does it update all of them or just some of them? Let's start with the filter control. So if I go to edit mode and show you how this filter control has been configured, we will see that filter control has a data source associated with it, and then a dimension or a field from that data source. The data source for this filter control is Facebook ads, and that means that with this control, we can only filter the numbers on this part of the report. Let's review and try it out. Now I'm trying to see only impression device equals to desktop. And as you can see, Microsoft Ads remains the same. And if we interact more with this filter control, The only numbers that are going to change on this report are the numbers associated with Facebook ads. If I want to filter the Google Ads number, for example, I either need to add another filter control or I need to change the data source for the filter control on this page. So if I change the data source to Google Ads, and it automatically changes the dimensions from impression device to device, because that's how they call it in a Google Ads data connector. Now we can go to view mode and select this, select, let's say, computers, and everything will remain intact, and the only thing that will update are the Google Ads numbers. Now let's reset this one and see how a date range control behaves in such situations. Now I will try to change the date range to last month, for example, and apply. As you can see, all of the numbers on the report page are being updated. And Microsoft Ads in particular is taking too long to send data to Google Data Studio. Okay, but it's at least good news. We don't have to create one date range control for each of these data sources. As a rule of thumb, date control filters work on any data source with a properly formatted default date field, which in this case, all of these four different data sources have a properly formatted date field inside them. So the date range control works completely fine on this report. That's it. I hope you enjoyed this video and you've learned how to add multiple data sources to a single Data Studio report, and that you can improve your Data Studio reports from now on using what you've learned today.
That's it. I hope you enjoyed this video and you can use what you've learned to improve your Data Studio dashboards. If you're new to Measure School, make sure to subscribe so you can get notified of the future videos that we publish. And if you have any questions, please feel free to leave a comment. This is Ahmed. See you in the next video.